Are you wondering if petroleum engineering is a valuable career? If you are interested in earth science and you like the idea of getting paid to travel the world, then you should consider becoming a petroleum engineer. A bachelor's degree in petroleum engineering is the most valuable bachelor's degree one can have. Petroleum engineering has historically been one of the highest paid engineering disciplines, and experienced petroleum engineers can choose to live almost anywhere in the world. My name is Furkan and I am principal process engineer with over 15 years of experience from petroleum engineering. Petroleum engineers seek out oil and gas reservoirs beneath the surface of Earth. They develop the safest and most efficient methods of bringing those resources to the surface. And as demands increase for alternative energy, some forward-thinking petroleum engineers are turning their talent to work on clean energy products that produce fewer harmful carbon emissions. After locating reservoirs of crude oil and natural gas, petroleum engineers find ways to bring the product out of the ground for processing. The two primary ways of getting the reserves to the surface are drilling and producing. Drilling creates a tunnel down to the oil and involves creating a system of pipes and valves to bring it up. Once a reserve has been located, the petroleum engineers must determine the quality and the quantity of the product to be extracted. Is there enough oil of sufficient quality to make the investment in money and labor worth the effort? Petroleum engineers examine the recovered oil and gas for quality before separating the different elements. They often find a mixture of oil, gas, water, and other components that must be separated and refined. They also design and develop the physical plant necessary for carrying it out these tasks safely and efficiently. Well, petroleum engineering education, it's pretty broad. There are so many different areas. So we are looking at rock properties and fluid properties. We need to understand how the fluids behave under the ground. We also need to understand how those fluids flow through the reservoir. We need to focus on things like drilling. So we focus on the drilling and the mechanics of actually placing a well in the ground. We then focus on maximizing the production and how we size pumps that go down into the wells. Then we also look into the reservoir aspects and even things like modeling the reservoir three-dimensionally. So when you look at all those components, we also have to have things like geology involved in it. We have to have things like programming and quite a bit of computer knowledge in that. We have to integrate with other disciplines like geophysics, geology, and mechanical engineering. Petroleum engineering students take basic engineering courses before moving into more specialized classes. Geologists look for crude oil and natural gas by studying rock formations and cuttings from drilling sites. They can analyze data from geological surveys, field maps, and seismic studies to help identify reservoirs. Geophysicists study the Earth's external and internal compositions. They examine ground and surface water, atmosphere, and magnetic and gravitational fields. They combine the principles of mathematics, physics, and chemistry along with the three-dimensional computer modeling to locate oil and gas reserves. A drilling operation can cost millions of dollars. Therefore, it's necessary to determine the best and most economical plan for drilling. The drilling engineer works with the drilling contractors to confirm the location and design a procedure to accomplish their task. Before, during, and after drilling project, the well log analyst is responsible for obtaining core samples and analyzing them for potential. Analysts must use sophisticated equipment such as electronic, nuclear, and acoustic tools. They rely on their talents to meaningfully interpret the data from these systems. Once a well has been drilled, the production engineer must determine the best way to bring the petroleum to the surface. To achieve as much profit as possible from a well, companies need to bring as much oil to the surface as possible. The reservoir engineer, often working in conjunction with the production engineer, examines the fluid and pressure distribution throughout the reservoir to achieve maximum results. The safety engineers keep track of safety regulations and are responsible for ensuring the safety of the people who work around the oil and natural gas. Environmental specialists work with a team of experts and they make sure all environmental regulations are met. Chemical engineers might be involved in anything from designing a plant for processing oil to researching new products or improving current production. Petroleum accountants are charged with placing a value on the oil and gas that might be produced in the future, thereby establishing corporate assets. The energy economist must analyze business conditions and develop financial strategies that are critical to the company's success. Facility engineers' role is to provide technical support for oil and gas processing equipment above the surface. So the facility engineers separate, process and transport the oil and natural gas after it has been brought to the surface. They are responsible for working with operations personnel to improve the efficiency of existing systems. They also design and build pipelines to move the petroleum from the drill site all the way to the point of sale. Examples of facility engineers are process engineers, mechanical, HVAC, electrical engineer, piping engineer, automation engineer, instrument engineer, technical safety, and etc. I'll talk about these engineers in more detail in my next video. What trends are you seeing in oil and gas today? Well, this is a very common question. Overall trends that we are seeing from an education standpoint, we are seeing more and more interest in data analytics. There are also more of programming desire, which I think fits with the data analytics, but it's also fitting with the ability of engineers to program the tools that they need. The industry is constantly changing. It's constantly expanding, so we have to stay innovative. We are getting into areas like geothermal and carbon capture and storage and production of hydrogen gas. Well, that brings me to the end of this video. See you in my next video where I will talk about different facility engineers. Take care and bye for now.